Hello everybody, welcome to Junair's wheel refurbishment process. I'm John Brown and I'm going to be taking you through step by step so you too can repair wheels to a high standard quickly and easily. The wheels have already been removed from the vehicle, so at this stage have a good look around the wheel, checking for other damage such as buckles or any deep damage to the spokes. Roll the wheel over to the wheel blaster. I'm placing the wheel into the blaster, ensuring that the centre of the wheel loads carefully onto the stem. Slide it back into position inside the cabinet. The system is designed to make loading more comfortable. Ensure the door is locked. Turn on the blaster and check your pressure and the media are all good to go, as the pressure can differ depending on what type of job you're doing. Blast the surface of the wheel until a matte finish is achieved. My preference is to spray the surface of the wheel as if you were painting it, moving the wheel around with your other hand. Try and cover a small section at a time and make sure you've covered the whole wheel surface. Try not to go over the same area repeatedly. Once you're happy that this stage has been completed, blow off as much media as you can, not forgetting to blow the door off before opening the machine. The finish gives approximately that of a 500 grade sanding finish. Wipe as much dust off as you can. Unload the wheel from the blaster and carefully place it onto the door of the wheel washer. Roll the wheel inside the machine and put on a 1 minute washing cycle. Once the washing cycle is complete, run a drying cycle, so this takes the majority of the water and the dust off the wheel. The benefit of a wheel washer is that after blasting, not only does it clean it properly, but it takes a lot of the static out of the wheel. Without this machine, dust can be attracted to the wheel surface. If the damage has gone around the outside edge of the rim, you will need to break the bead so the damage can be sanded out properly. But in this case, there's no need to do that. Place the wheel onto the wheel bench for sanding operations. Our prep bench has a built-in extraction and filters, as it is very difficult to collect the dust using a conventional extraction tool. Sand away the damage using an orbital sander, this size 75mm or 150mm if you prefer. First, I'm going to use a 180 grit sanding disc. Then I'm going to move on to a 320 grit sanding disc before finishing with a 500 grit sanding disc, or smoother if you prefer. If this is not done correctly, marks will be visible under the top coat, which can result in a costly rework, so the finer the better. Clean the wheel with a good quality degreaser to remove any dirt and grease from the surface. Blow off any remaining dust and water. Mask over the tyre with a plastic bag, paper or 2-inch tape. At this stage, the wheel preparation is complete. Always make time to check it thoroughly before painting, as things are a lot easier to rectify at this stage than during or after paint.